Welcome to my short video on creating a production routing using Dynamics NAV. In this video, what I'll show you is how to create a production routing for a front wheel that you can use to associate to a bomb and a routing and then later use in production. Here we have our role center for Dynamics NAV. We can start typing the word routings in order to find our routings list, or on your navigation pane, you may have a shortcut that exists already in which you can just click to open up your routings list. As you can see here, I don't have a routing for my front wheel. So what I want to do is I want to go up to my ribbon and I want to select new. So as you can see here, I've got a new screen that's populated blank for me. And as we can see from the top title, it's a new routing. First thing we want to do is we want to indicate a number for this routing. In a lot of cases, we just call the routing the same as we've called the item and the production bomb, and it sort of creates a soft link between the three so that we know that they're related. In some instances, you may find that your routing works for a variety of different items, in which case you don't want to have sort of a one-to-one relationship with the item. You can call the routing whichever you like, and you might want a more generic name in that case. For my case, I want to call it the 1100FW, 1100 being my item card, and FW is what I've named the bomb, so I want to have that link between the two. And I'm going to call it here a front wheel. Under type, we have two types that you can select for a routing, one being serial, one being parallel. Serial indicates to me that in my line section, I've indicated the operation number, basically outlining the series that I want my work center to go into. So for example, if I need it to go to assembly, then to deburring, then to final inspection, then to a shipping department, I can outline that and all of the steps have to be followed in that order. 40 follows 30, 30 follows 20, 20 follows 10. I can also set up a parallel routing, which basically indicates that I can indicate a series of work centers or machine centers, and then using next operation, last operation, I can have two work centers or machine centers go through a routing at the exact same time, allowing me to do two concurrently. For the purposes of this demonstration, I'm going to keep it as serial. The status defaults to new when I'm creating a new routing. And now what we need to focus on is our line section, because we need to tell NAV what are the routing steps in the work centers or machine centers that this process needs to go through in order to create the front wheel. So the first thing I want to do is I want to indicate my operation number for the first operation, which I'm going to indicate here as 10. I need to select the type, so whether I'm using a machine center or a work center. Based on my setup, I'm using work center, so I'm going to select that. What I would need to do now is I need to indicate the work center number for what I need for my first step, which I can do by manually typing in and selecting from the list, or I could have used my lookup here and selected from there if I wasn't 100% sure of the number off the top of my head. It automatically pulls the description in from the work center based again on my setup. Here I need to indicate the setup time, and as I can see here by the setup time unit of measure, it's indicating that how many minutes of setup do I need to be able to create a front wheel at the assembly step. So you can indicate your setup by minutes, hours, days, however you want. That's completely defined by you. Here we've set up minutes, and I want to indicate that it's 60 minutes to set up the assembly department in order to create one front wheel. Then I want to jump over to my runtime section, and this is asking what is the runtime that that work center needs in order to create a front wheel. In this scenario, it's 5. Later, when that gets used on a production order, the 5 will be times by the quantity in order to get me the estimated time for the assembly department for that production run. So remember, we're just doing the routing master for it, so we just need to know how long would it take for one piece to go through. You can indicate a wait and a move time if there's some indirect time that gets added to the routing steps in order to use for planning. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to continue adding routing steps for the additional stages that this part needs to go through in order to come out a front wheel. So I'm going to add another operation number, and this time I'm going to call it 20. So as you can see, I've increased by 10. I like to do that because then at a later stage, say if I had quality issues or I wanted to put a note in between my first and second routing line, I would be able to do that by indicating that it was operation number 15, which allows me some flexibility to put additional routing steps in between two existing routing steps at a later date if needed. So here I'll indicate another work center that it needs to go to, which is painting. Painting maybe takes 90 minutes to set up, and perhaps it's 45 minutes for a runtime. Maybe I've got then 120 minutes, so 2 hours that it's going to take to wait, so it takes to dry, and I have no move time. Again, I'm going to increase by 30. And as I mentioned before, I can use my drop down so that I can select the proper work center that it goes to. Packaging has no setup time, and it takes me about 15 minutes to package. Once I'm satisfied with all of the steps that it's taken to go through to create the front wheel, I can go up again to my header and select Certified from my status, which now means that this is ready to be used in production. If you have any questions, please contact www.sabrelimited.com or call 519-585-7524.